Hey there. Welcome to Elevated Daily, the show where we go ahead and talk about past and present pop culture shows, films, and entertainment. I'm your host, Gabe, and today we're going to dive into the Harley Quinn series. This is season 1, episode 6, titled You're a Damn Good Cop, Jim Gordon. Now, so far, this series has been just unbelievable for me. I have had nonstop laughs. The animation is great. The voice acting is great. Even some of the storylines have been a little bit emotional, especially for those of us that have ever had any kind of trauma or a really hard breakup. Believe it or not, this show does kind of delve into that. Well, in any case, in today's episode that we're going to go ahead and review, Harley goes ahead and tries and breaks into Wayne Tech. Clayface loses an arm, and then that arm becomes friends with Jim Gordon. Meanwhile, Batman's dealing with his own issues. Ivy's dealing with some unwanted attention. So what's going to happen to our favorite anti-heroes and villains? How's Jim Gordon going to react to Clayface's friendship? Harley Quinn ever going to get into the Legion of Doom? These are some of the questions I want to know. Come join me and watch the reaction and stay for the review portion, and we'll go ahead and have that discussion. Got some groove going on. Pretty groovy.
T-Rex bones
so
just come
relaxing
to life and then chase that guard?
Wait, did you just steal King Tut's body? Ugh, I was gonna go see that on Sunday.
See it? Now you can touch it!
Yeah, but I've never been, like, in a museum and thought, oh, I wish I could touch this dead body.
Well, someone must wanna, because it was under heavy guard.
And we needed a new ottoman.
We'll get used to it. The news must be all over this. Let's see what they're saying about us on villainy.evil.
A new ottoman,
wait, what? KG Beast's getting nominated for the Legion of Doom? Well, I'm way better than him! People must be freaking out in the comments!
This was long overdue. Yay.
Worked with him on 3 assassinations. So professional. Couldn't have happened to a better guy. Screw you, better guy!
What the hell does it take to get nominated?
Ooh, look, here's one about you. Why's no one talking about Harley Quinn? I'd like to nominate her to sit on my face.
Oh, well, that, should have read it through.
Do you want to just, like, use your words?
I have been busting my ass to get noticed by the Legion for the last 2 months. I've done everything there is to do.
You mean we've done?
Yeah, I was using the royal eye. Sorry for the rant. I'm fine now. Okay, now I'm fine.
Hey, so I can't help but notice that you're being extra Harley today. And I just honestly, I don't understand your obsession with the Legion of Doom. I mean, those guys are genuinely pieces of shit.
Yeah, obviously. But those pieces of shit are the only people Joker ever treated as equals. I'll never match up to him unless I'm in the Legion too.
Okay, so what you're saying is you're not over your ex and you want to throw your success in his face.
Exactly.
Honestly, that might be the most relatable thing you've ever said.
All right, people, listen, I want ideas. Something that's gonna get us on the Legion of Doom's radar.
I could call my old pal Hank Kissinger. I'm sure he has a few war crimes he never pulled off.
I know we're criminals, but are we really war criminals?
No one thinks they're a war criminal. Then you find yourself aiding a separatist movement to overthrow a democratically elected leader and boom! You're a war criminal.
Maybe we could steal some new computers, because the one you smashed was mine.
That's a maniac.
That's it. Wayne Tech.
You want to legally purchase computers.
I wasn't thinking legal, and I wasn't thinking computers. We're going to rob Bruce Wayne.
I mean, that's going to work out well.
All right, this is what we're going after.
It's beautiful.
And on the 26th floor.
Cool. How are we gonna get it down?
We'll Fast and Furious 7 it. Guys, that's the one where they shoot a car from one skyscraper into another skyscraper, but you know, ultimately, they're just all about family. Clayface, activate Operation Douche.
Yeah, I don't think that's real.
Sir, please, have you seen my daughter? I mean, well, technically, I'm not her father. I mean, you see, the Lord hath cursed me with empathy. It's for my wife's strain. It's an emotionally complex tale that if you have 2 hours to spare, I can burden you with my tale of woe.
Harley, thank you for letting me use my brains for once.
Most people don't let me be who I am.
Ah. Ooh, okay, I see what we're working with here.
Oh,
I can
damn
take the first 3 doors, but the retinal scanner at the entrance to the room is on you.
Here we go.
Why was she put down so gently?
Because she's not a misogynist troll that should be living in a well.
Psycho, focus!
Damn. Straight evil to Psycho.
Beautiful in person.
Don't forgetting that they are still bad guys killing and maiming everybody.
So we can get the hell out of here. Hello? What the hell are you
even
doing?
Stealing whatever's in here. It's even more restricted.
Oh, perfect. Even more restricted. You're the psycho.
Mind you, that wasn't the first time I was cuckolded.
His arm.
It's too late. We gotta go.
But my arm. You just called an audible. Can't we call another one and get my limb?
Can't you just grow a new one? Where the fuck is Psycho?
Who is that? I am a golden god.
Oh, you little beggar. Don't you?
They're so fucked up to him. They're so damn mean.
What's wrong?
It's Barb. You know, she's sleeping with someone else, and the worst part, I can't blame her. I mean, a woman can only go so long watching the dead eyes of her lover thrust atop her before she looks for something.
My arm!
It's too late! We gotta go!
With my arm!
You this is about the breakdown of my marriage!
The signal is for emergencies.
Well...
emergencies. You've abused it.
Look, my personal life is a mess right now, and I thought I could talk about it with my friend.
We're co-workers. Harley stole some highly sensitive tech from Wayne Enterprises. In her hands, it could be catastrophic.
Oh, well,
then I'm on it,
signal.
Co-worker.
Here, evidence from the crime scene.
Yeah, what's that?
Ask it yourself. You used to be such a damn good cop.
I damn still am.
Prove it.
Yeah.
Kind of a dick, huh?
Oh, that was awesome. Everyone kicked major ass. I mean, Psycho, when you froze that security guard, mwah.
Ah, don't you dare Italian chef finger kiss any part of that disaster. You screwed up the plan.
I'm ready for the heist. And it's a gone and we delicious.
Shit, I missed the heist, didn't I?
If you could call it that. Clayface lost his arm.
No, it's fine. I'll just play one-armed characters for the rest of my career. Perhaps they'll make a sequel to 127 Hours. There has been light buzz.
You guys are thinking small time, all right? This is a way bigger score than that bike. This thing is a highly classified technological device that's gonna blow the minds of the Legion of Doom.
You have no idea what that does, do you?
Yes, I do! Something button related? Look, either way, it is obviously important. I bet you this heist all over the news. I mean, look, this is what I'm talking about. We even got reviewed by the cowled critic. I mean, he's like the only reviewer the Legion of Doom reads.
All right, I learned something today, cowheads, and that is Harley Quinn and her crew are worthy of Legionnaire's disease, let alone the Legion of Doom.
Wait, what?
Well, what should I have expected when the crew has the universally hated Dr. Psycho and his hussy new girlfriend,
Oh, fuck off. That is completely out of context.
There we go.
I knew I should have let you fall to your death.
And the pièce de résistance? Harley Quinn is so inept, she left behind a member of her own team who is now in the hands of the Gotham Police.
What the hell's he talking about? We all made it back in one piece.
Not exactly. Tell me where Harley Quinn is.
I just want to get back to my dad!
All right, okay. How about if you tell me about him?
I can't, because I'm not supposed to talk to strangers!
Oh, but I'm not a
stranger. No, my name is Jim. Oh, I'm a hardworking detective with a beautiful wife. That's who won't touch me, even though I treat her like a queen and do everything for her. Everything! But that's not your problem.
Oh, she doesn't sound like a friend to me.
That's exactly what I've been saying to anyone who would listen to me, which is no one. But that's not what we're here to talk about.
But maybe it should be, Jim.
My God, you're right.
So it knows everything you know?
Yes, we've been over this. My arm Gordon is a piece of me.
But it wouldn't give away our location, turn us in, testify against us, would it?
Who knows? It's like a kid. It'll do anything for approval.
I wonder where I got that from.
Ugh, if he squeals, the cowled critic will have a field day and the Legion of Doom will never take me.
But mostly we'll all be in prison for the rest of our lives.
Oh, yeah, that too.
And I'll never get my lost little right-hand man back.
Yeah, that too.
Hey. You know what? I think I speak for everyone when I say that this is completely fucking stupid. Can you please fire me now so I can get some unemployment?
Okay, no one's going anywhere, because we are going to rescue your arm. We are going to break into the Gotham City Police Department. If we pull it off, the Legion will call us in no time. Oh, and Clayface will have two arms.
Look, I'd love to come along and support you, but...
But you want to find the critic that said you're the biggest fuck-up on my crew and tear him a new asshole. I get it.
I will not be slandered!
I'll help you smack him around a little bit. What? For you, obviously. I mean, I can't let this anonymous asshole talk shit about my best friend, right?
Well, Ive, you'd hurt him for me.
Yes, absolutely.
Yes, for her.
And because he claimed I'm fucking psycho. But mostly for you, babe. But also for me. But for you. For us. It's fine. Let's go!
Well, I can't believe that bad old Batman took away your special signal.
After all the cases I've helped him solve, I'm the one that does the grunt work.
All I ask is that occasionally when my wife is emotionally distant during sex, he listens. Not to the sex, but to me talking about the...
Yeah. Jim, you sound like a really good cop.
You know, it's just been so long since I've heard someone else say that. I was just starting to wonder if it was really true.
It's true to me. Friend.
A one-armed officer. The stories my mind is weaving. Ooh, how did he lose it? A shootout, maybe? An explosion, perhaps? I know. Diabetes!
So, when they arrest me, I go full shark and start a riot to cause a distraction?
Yep, easy as one, two,
three.
Okay, plan B. Clayface, you gotta distract him.
Brilliant! What do cops love? It is I again, your fellow officer. Hello, chums. I come bearing horrible news. Joker has kidnapped Bruce Springsteen.
Some rat fuck stole the boss!
Don't worry, the boss.
We're coming for you, boss!
Hello? My husband's been murdered and the killer's still in the house.
Come on. Just tell me where Harley's lair is. I'm your friend, not them. You said it yourself.
You mean that? You're not just pretending?
Well, I'm not gonna lie to you. I was. But then, you listened to me. Graphically explained the problematic intercourse I'm having with my wife and...
Gosh darn it, you didn't judge me.
Well, Jim, you can't judge what you don't understand.
God, you're so wise.
Well, thanks, friend. You know what? I'm gonna tell you where the lair is. The lair is on...
Don't tell him anything!
My child!
Give us the arm, Gordon, now!
Oh, Jim, don't let him take me. You need me, right? Because I'm evidence!
Oh, hold on there, crazy guy. You're a lot more than just evidence. And I'm not gonna let these animals touch you. If you've got ears, stick your fingers in them right now because I'm about to work blue. I'm gonna fuck you to death with bullets.
So, you found the cowled critic's house because you
heard it through the grapevine. Yeah, it is a real thing.
Oh, shit! It's you! Of course it's you!
Who's she?
My ex-wife.
Why are you at my boyfriend's house?
Quick sidebar, how did this work sexually?
Not great! Oh, I should have called this. I know you're the cowled critic. You gave that review saying me and Chickweed here are a couple.
You think I care about you and your jolly green whore?
Okay, I'm standing right here.
I don't have time to give some review. I'm too busy getting cunnilingus from my new boyfriend, Brad, who's amazing at it.
Oh, come on. Only weak men do that.
Oh, fucking hell.
Call me. In other news, if you didn't write the review, who did?
Father?
Herman?
Just give us the arm, Gordon.
You'll have to kill me first. He's my friend. My only friend.
What about Batman?
He's no friend. Now that Batman's abandoned me, this hand is all I have. So you'll just have to pry this hand out of my cold, dead hand.
Why did you just leave us alone?
What he said!
Okay, he's siding with Gordon. He's gonna snitch and ruin everything, and I will never get into the Legion!
And I'd like to have two arms.
Oh, yeah, that too. All right, two options, Gordy. Give us the arm and we leave, or I press this button and blow this whole fucking place sky high!
Harley, that wasn't the plan. We have no idea what that button does.
I gotta do something crazy, and in the chaos, we'll grab the arm.
Okay, you winked. Is that a wink that, no, I'm not going to press the button? Is that a wink? I am going to press the button. What's the plan?
Exactly.
What?
You've got 3 seconds to put that button down, or I'll pull this trigger, so help me God. 3, 2, 1.
Oh, well, I wasn't expecting that.
Just take her to the Batcave.
What the hell?
So, Quinn, you press the button.
Yeah, I don't think you got all the kinks worked out.
It's in beta.
Wow, I always wondered what the Batcave looked like. So this must be where you fuck the bats.
Hmm.
Are you gonna help me or what?
You've seen the Batcave. Give me one reason why I shouldn't let you drop.
Hey, Bats! Yeah, I'm here on a mercy mission, okay? Gordon's on the roof of the police department. He's lost his mind. I mean, I think he's suicidal. He said you abandoned him.
I don't know what he wants from me. We're co-workers. My screensaver just kicked in, didn't it?
Yeah, it sure did. I mean, he said he put your work before your friendship. That's real selfish. You know, Bats, now that I think about it, you and I ain't that different.
We're completely different.
We're both badasses who look good in spandex.
This polymer body armor is made from indestructible microfiber.
Yeah, no, it looks like spandex. My friend just lost his arm, and instead of helping him get it back, I did what would help me get into the Legion of Doom. I let him down, just like you let Gordon down.
Not good at emotion.
Or vocabulary. But hey, you got a chance to repair it, okay? We need to get Gordon before he does something crazy. Your friend needs you now.
Herman, my sweet Herman. Listen, I understand your monster mom saying those things about me, but my brood? My own kin?
You made my entire life a living hell. You locked me in the basement for days?
Uh-huh.
Killed anyone who seemed to like me?
That's true.
Never bought me a Wayne Station 4.
All right.
Fuck, you named me Herman! You're the worst father ever!
Okay, can we just take a step back? I made your life a living hell because I care about you.
What?
Supervillains don't come from happy homes, and I saw so much evil potential in you. If I didn't think you can become the worst person in the world, I wouldn't have tried so hard to make your life awful!
I only ever wanted to impress you, but I never thought I was evil enough.
No, don't cry. You're gonna make me cry, because I thought I failed as a father, and you ended up happy and heroic. But look at you. You're more evil than I could have dreamed. I couldn't be more proud of you, my terrible son.
I hate you, Dad. I hate you so much.
I hate you too, son.
This is so fucked up, but weirdly really moving.
All right, I'm gonna let you guys go. I'm gonna go find Brad.
If you want to stay with Gordon, I understand. I only want you to be safe.
So twisted.
Safe and happy.
Holy shit! Can we do that again?
No.
Oh, so you came back. Well, I've got a new friend now, so there's nothing you can say.
I'm sorry, Jim.
I'm sorry, too. I knew you'd realize our friendship means more than just our day-to-day crime fighting, and that we can lean on each other for our most intimate emotional needs.
Sure. A damn good bat signal.
Well.
For a damn good cop.
Aw. Oh. Thank you for everything, the arm. But I've got my real friend back now, so you can go on. Go get Reabsorb back into your daddy. Oh, don't do that. Don't make this harder than it needs to be.
Oh, Jim, I'll never forget you.
Well done.
All right, Quinn. Time for me to take you to Arkham.
Wait, what? I just repaired your most important adult relationship.
Back to the Batcave. I love it.
Everybody hands up!
Hands in the air!
You're under arrest!
Not so fast, gentlemen.
Stand, coppers!
Come on, let's go! Let's get out of here!
What a pussy!
And so it is, with a humble heart, that I come to you, cowheads, retracting my previous review. Harley Quinn and her crew have more than proven themselves.
Look, obviously I want to get into the Legion of Doom super bad. It's incredibly important to me, but not more important than you guys.
Check this out, everybody!
And I want to give a special shout-out to Dr. Psycho, who I slandered in my last review, feeling really bad about that. Using his amazing brain powers, he made Batman vanish. His super cool son must be so proud.
That's not what I...
Let him have this.
Also want to apologize for saying Poison Ivy and Dr. Psycho are a couple. That one's on me.
Ah, thank
you. Finally.
God. Harley Quinn and her crew are worthy of being nominated for this year's class of the Legion of Doom. Don't let it just stop leaving crew members behind.
We didn't leave anybody... Oh, shit.
Daryl, if you ever bring me inferior toilet wine again, I'll be forced to shank you in the showers, and you know I don't want to do that. I like being cool, boss.
Hey, King, I am so sorry for leaving you here so long.
Oh, no problem. It allowed me to experience firsthand the failings of the prison industrial complex.
Yeah, fresh fish!
Now, fellas, look, I know it's just in fun, but what the fuck did I tell you about that word?
Oh, yeah, sorry, King.
Ooh, sorry about that.
Oh, they're learning. Baby steps. Right
on. I will kill each and every one of you with my bare hands if I have to.
Hey, everyone, thanks for staying. I'm Elevated Daily. Now's the portion of our show where we go ahead and jump into our review. This episode, I'm going to give 4 out of 5 high guys. This was great. It was hilarious again. It had emotion. It showed us a little bit more about Jim Gordon and Batman's history. So I was digging on that. Let's go ahead and jump into this review. This episode starts with Harley Quinn deciding that she wants to go ahead and rob Wayne Tech. They want to steal a device that's going to hack into any computer in the world from Wayne Tech, hopefully impressing the Legion and Doom so Harley can go ahead and get on in there. But in all the chaos, we have King Shark biting off heads. We have Harley making an audible to go ahead and steal another device that is even more protected than the original device she was going to steal. We get Clayface losing his arm and that becoming a whole another subplot with Gordon on there. Gordon has a little falling out with Batman. Ivy and Dr. Psycho get some unwanted attention together and they go off on their own adventure to go ahead and solve that issue. Gordon is crazy. Gordon is having such a rough time apparently with his marriage and his wife and his personal life that he's just, as you could see in the show, he's just falling apart. Goes to Batman for some sympathy to go ahead and talk to what he thinks is his friend, and Batman just turns his shoulders on him and in fact goes ahead and takes back the bat signal and telling Jim he used to be a damn good cop. What happened? It was actually kind of messed up to watch to see that Batman just can't socialize. He'd rather, it's crime fighting and that's that, and just cut out his friend like that and that was messed up. Back at Harley's hideout, the rest of the crew is pissed at her because she went ahead and left Clayface's arm behind. She called an audible, completely changing the plan, all because of what she wanted to go ahead and succeed to impress the Legion of Doom. They don't agree with her putting their lives on the line for something like that, and it's selfish. So when Harley comes up with the idea to kidnap Bruce Wayne, Ivy and Dr. Psycho are immediately out of it because they have their own issues that they want to go ahead and attend. The Cowled Critic on there talking crap, talking about how they're a couple now. Then we get to go ahead and see that the Cowled Critic is actually Psycho's son. They have this hate-hate relationship going on, and that was kind of funny, emotional, but as Ivy said, very messed up. And at the end of the episode, we go ahead and see Harley Quinn finally remembers that King Shark, another member of her crew, has also been incarcerated and they need to go rescue him. So they bust him out. And in the mid-credit scene, we see that they go back to Bruce Wayne's house to kidnap him and he traps them. So definitely want to go ahead and see how that's going to come out. What are your thoughts out there, YouTube? Are you digging on this show? Do you like it? Does it make you laugh? This show cracks me up. The animation, the voice acting. Christopher Maloney from SUV. He's Jim Gordon. Do y'all know that? This is just a great, great show. I mean, between Batman, Gordon, and Harley, just those three in general, those characters in themselves have me cracking up all the time, especially whenever they interact. But then you get Harley and her crew and their personalities. It just... this show is so over the top, zany, and funny that I don't ever want it at the end. Well, definitely like to hear your thoughts out there, YouTube. Drop me a line. Like, comment, and subscribe so we can have that discussion. Also, let me know what you think about our show. Subscribe, and we'll go ahead and produce more of these videos for y'all if you like them. All right. Well, until next time, I'm Gabe, and I'm Elevated Daily. Thank you for staying with me and spending some time. You could have been anywhere else in the world, but you hung with me for a little bit, and I appreciate that. You stay safe, and as always, stay elevated.